I was riding because I love the sport. A lot of my friends raced BMX at that time, so it was just like a big hangout. It was just fun thing to do after school. When I found out that the BMX could be part of Olympic Games, I was still an early age, probably 14, 15. I remember I was at my dad's work and I picked up the newspaper and that's where I read it. And then I was like, I mean, that's awesome. Someone's gonna go and compete for the gold medal. And at that point, I didn't really think it could be me. Even in Latvia, a lot of like the media, they counted me off. They like, you know, he's too young, he's probably not gonna handle the pressure. You know, to me it kind of helped. You know, I felt like there's really no pressure on me, no one's really waiting anything from me. And then I just went out there and I really had fun and I enjoyed it. In the gate, I mean, just try to stay focused and you just had to stay consistent and just do what I've been doing my whole life pretty much. And right now we're in the first turn when I was leading, and but coming out of the first turn, I over jumped the first step up and I knew at one point I thought I had it, and the next moment I thought, oh dang, I lost it. And then American guy had inside, so I thought, you know, he had a little bit of an advantage. But then the next two jumps, I jumped a little bit lower than him, gained a little more momentum. I held that inside line, and then coming out of the second turn, I knew, I mean, I can do it. I mean, it's up to me. So I just had to stay calm and ride with no mistakes, and then all the way to the finish line. And then that's what I tried to do. I mean, BMX, the thing is, you can't get excited too early. You gotta stay focused, you gotta do what you gotta do. When you cross the finish line, then you start thinking. I mean, to be honest, I didn't know what to do, you know. I crossed the line, I mean, what do I do now? I just won Olympic Games, so I just threw my bike away and it just happened automatically. It just came out, you know. I just got excited and then I think I ran to my coach and then hugged my coach and stuff like that. So I mean, it was a special moment. Yeah, it definitely brings back a lot of good memories. At that time, you don't really think it's that big of a deal till you actually get home and then you see all the media people paying attention to you, you know, the fans, you know, the people, and it, you know, and then you kind of, kicks in, and then you start realizing, oh, yeah, I guess it was a big thing. I can tell you that the time flies, you know, those 4 years just went by so fast, and the media people kept asking me, you know, what if you don't win? It makes you think about it. It's like, what if I don't win the gold medal anymore? What you know, how is it gonna be, you know, when you're not Olympic champion? You know, I got nothing to lose. I mean, I have a great opportunity to go to Olympics and try to win another gold medal. And that's how I look at it. Physically, I felt confident, but it's just mentally. If I go back and watch the whole race in London, I mean, I was struggling. I was struggling throughout the race, you know. If you look at it, I wasn't riding like myself a lot of times, and then just right before the main event, just got that feel for it, to be honest. And I always compare it to surfing. You know, when you try to surf and you have to try to get and stay on that board, you know, and catch that wave. And in BMX, same thing, when you catch that wave, everything just opens up and it just gets so much easier. And then that's what I was kind of waiting for, right before the main event. And I just had that feel that I caught the wave, and then I started feeling a lot more confident and I knew I can go out there and do it. Track was good, the weather was nice. I had lane three, and I think it was a good position. Yeah, usually I prefer either lane one or outside lane, like lane seven, lane eight. I think right when the gate dropped, I had a good, we call it 1, 2, 3, first three cranks, explosive, good, strong cranks. And at that moment I felt, I mean, I just got going right away and I felt like I'm in good position. But in BMX, like I said, you can't get excited too early. And after the second jump on the first straightaway, I took the lead, and then going into the first turn, I almost did the same thing what I did in Beijing. The first jump coming out of the first turn, a little bit overjumped and jumped it too far and I lost a little bit of momentum. The next jump was a big step up, I remember, and then I felt that same Australian guy was right inside lane, and then when I jumped up when I was in the middle of the air, I started just pedaling. Like, even though you didn't really need to do it because it doesn't help you go any faster when you pedal in the air, but just in the moment I just didn't want to let my first position go, and I just started pedaling and just all the way basically to the finish line. I raised my hand up when I crossed Beijing, but in London when I crossed the finish line, I just screamed. That's what I did the first thing, because I think it just came so much harder, all that work I put in. And you know, as you get older, you start appreciating things a lot more. And then I just screamed and just kind of wanted to let it all out, because I really had a tough year, you know, going into Olympic Games, you know, some of the pressure and all that stuff. So I just let it all out. And then after then I was, you know, I hug my coach and all my parents, and then that's when I was getting all excited and happy. I mean, everything starts with picturing yourself and seeing yourself in that position, and then there's a good chance that your dream will come true, you know. And that's what I did before London. I think that was definitely one of my goals, to go out and because we all know it's so much harder to defend the title than to win the title. And after London, when I got back home to Latvia, I remember we got back home late, and the people were waiting at the airport. Even when I got to my hometown, it was midnight. Basically, the whole city was outside waiting, and there was this big, like, ceremony and everything. It's just one of a lifetime experience, to be honest, and it's crazy. It's something I'll never forget.